gentlemen, this next event here on World Championship Wrestling, introducing first from Knoxville, Tennessee, at 230 pounds, Larry Santo. And his partner at 220 pounds from Delray Beach, Florida, Sean Regal. And introducing their opponents, making their way to the ring area. Ladies and gentlemen, Lord Littlebrook presents from the Queen's Court, Rip Morgan and Jacko Victory, the Royal Family.
Well, there they are in their new regalia. Let's hear this short statement from Lord Littlebrook.
Don't miss it. Tomorrow, the Dynamic Dudes will be taking on my team, the New Zealand Militia, now known as the Royal Family. You're in for one heck of a night for wrestling, so be there, watch it, we're going to win.
Well, I'll tell you something. Scott Steiner won the most improved wrestler of 1989. If the New Zealand are, well, they're not the New Zealand Militia any longer. They're the Royal Family. And if they continue to improve, they may be leading contenders for the most improved in 1990.
They certainly are. Since Littlebrook's come upon the scene, they're undefeated. They've given everybody a run for their money. And take a look at these guys, the teamwork now. The difference was before Littlebrook, it was two individuals like we talked about the match earlier. Two individuals that didn't know how to work as a team. They're meshing as a team now. They're undefeated. Hey, and they could give the Steiners a run for the money. They could give anybody, including the Mighty Road Warriors.
They'll be on the NWA main event this Sunday, 6:05 against the Dynamic Dudes. Nice move there by Larry Santo, the Leapfrog. Really to no avail there is Big Rip Morgan. Really nailed him. I want to remind you that the NWA main event this Sunday night, 6:05, the heavyweight championship of the world return match, Nature Boy, Ric Flair, and Bobby here on TBS. That's at 6:05 this Sunday night. And Kevin Sullivan, that is great teamwork.
That's what we're talking about. They didn't do this 6 weeks ago. Littlebrook's there. Somebody's taught them this stuff. This is great teamwork.
You know, I said, Kevin, a few weeks ago, we talked about their progress, and I spoke to Gordon Soley about it. I think the biggest difference in the Royal Family is the fact that they have confidence in themselves. They feel that every time the bell rings, they're going to win. And that's something that their erstwhile leader from England has instilled in them.
Jim, we've talked about this before. It's like when you go out to Boston Gardens and play the Celtics there, you know you can't beat them in their home court. These guys know they're winners. They know they've been instilled with a winning tradition now with Littlebrook, and they know they're going to win. Look at these guys. They're more aggressive than they've ever been.
Littlebrook lecturing Sean Regal there. After he got through his dissertation, he turned to Jacko Victory loose on him.
You know, I know that Scott Steiner won the most improved wrestler, but Jacko Victory had to be a close runner-up.
Perhaps that could be true. Fans, remember that next time the NWA live in Atlanta will be in the Omni on the Friday night, January 26th. Phenomenal card already signed, of which we'll be speaking to you about throughout the program for our fans in Atlanta. And Jacko Victory with a neck vice on Sean Regal. Our second hour really packed with excitement. I'll be talking live to Lex Luger and the Rock and Roll Express. We'll see the new skyscrapers in action. Tommy Rich will be with us, the Wild Samoans. I'll be speaking to Michael Hayes, and we'll see Arn Anderson and Sting in tag team action. Regal sent for the ride and nailed by that flying elbow by Jacko. I tell you, the Steiners are really ecstatic, Kevin, about being back in Saginaw, Michigan, their home state this Tuesday night. That's at the Saginaw, Michigan Civic Center, or the NWA, with over 30 starters there this Tuesday night. And that is a 7:30 starting time in Saginaw. Wednesday night, the NWA in Toledo, Ohio. Thursday night in Hammond, Indiana. This Friday night in Flying Brian's hometown. He'll be in Cincinnati at the Cincinnati Gardens. And 1 week from tonight, we'll be in beautiful Charleston, West Virginia at the Civic Center.
Jim, I've watched this match. The Royal Family, as they're called now, they have made one mistake, not one. Everything they've done, they've executed to 100%. This is what makes a top tag team.
I'll tell you, it's like a coach, and, you know, getting a new job in the pros and making a team a winner. And that's what Lord Littlebrook has done here. Their tactics are somewhat questionable at times, but he has got on the Queen, apparently, or some representative from England has endowed them with these outfits and new motivations.
Beautiful, double boot. That's where we differ, Jim Ross. You say they're questionable, they're tactics. The only thing that matters in life is winning. It doesn't matter how you play the game, it's whether you win or lose. And the Royal Family is obviously winning this match with that move right there.
Great move right there, double face first suplex, and the Royal Family have chalked up another victory.
Is Littlebrook putting the boots to him?
Littlebrook there.
Yeah, boy. I like that, Jim. I like that.
Well, at least it makes small bruises.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the event, the Royal Family.
And let's take another look at it, Kevin. We've got, we're going to be talking to the fans here in a moment, but look at this.
Picking them up, drives them face first down, and it's all over. Another win for the Royal Family.